In the last video, we have seen to how to find the minimum spanning tree using the Prim's algorithm. So next in this video, we are going to see again how to find the minimum spanning tree using the another algorithm, that is Kruskal's algorithm. What is the main difference here in Prim's algorithm and Kruskal's algorithm? Here is, in Kruskal's algorithm, it is considering one extra concept, that is, if the vertex is having n edges. If the vertex is having n vertices, okay, if the vertex is having n vertices, then its minimum spanning tree is found out which is having n minus 1 edges. This is the extra concept which is present in the Kruskal's algorithm, and the tabular method is also different. Here again we are finding the minimum spanning tree. What is a spanning tree? A spanning tree is a subgraph of a graph where all the vertices should be included, they should be connected, and there should be no cycle in the subgraph. That is called as a spanning tree. And that spanning tree which is having the minimum cost is called as the minimum spanning tree. So we are going to find the minimum spanning tree using the Kruskal's algorithm. This Kruskal's, Prim's, Dijkstra's, all these are names of the people, those who have invented these algorithms. Okay, so now here, as I already told you, when graph G of V, E is considered, which is having n vertices, then Kruskal's algorithm finds the MST, that is minimum spanning tree with n minus 1 number of edges present in its minimum spanning tree. And it should also satisfy all those three properties. That is, it should have all the vertices, it should be connected, and it should be a cyclic. Here, two concepts we have to consider in this Kruskal's algorithm, that is find of u and union of ij. What is this find of u? Find of u, this function finds the root node of this vertex u. It finds the root vertex of this u. Consider this as a graph, okay? Now where 4, 8, 6, all these three are having 1 as the root node, okay? So if I am having here 1, 2 and 3. 2 and 3 are having 1 as its root node. Like this. Find of u will find out the root of this vertex u. So that is what I have done here. Next is union of ij. Here now we are considering S1, S2, S3, S4 and S5 are sets. In those sets we are having their root nodes. Set S1's root node is 1. S2's root node is 2, S3 is 3, and so on. When you want to union these two sets, so now here this set representation I have done here in array representation. So S1's root node is 1, S2's root node is 2, S3's root node is 3. Now when you want to find out the union of S1 and S2. So S1 union, yes, all of you know this is a union symbol. So S1 union S2. What does this mean is store the root node of S1 in S2. What does this mean? Store the root node of S1 in as the root node of S2. Okay. Now what is the root node of S1? See, S1's root node is 1. So store 1 as the root node of S2. So what was the root node of S2? 2. But when I do S1 union S2, so I am storing the root node of S1, that is 1, in this one, that is S2. So this is called as the union, where you are storing root node of one vertex into the as the root node of another vertex. So this is union. These two concepts we are going to use when solving the problem of this Kruskal's algorithm of finding the minimum spanning tree. Okay. So here is an example of the Kruskal's algorithm. This is the given graph. Okay. So this is again a graph, undirected graph, where we are having 0 to 8, means totally 9 vertices are there. So out of 9 vertices, if n is the vertex number, means here vertex n is equal to how much? 9. N minus 1 means 8 edges will be considered by this Kruskal's algorithm. Okay. So this is the edge. What are the steps followed here in this example is, so each one first, each of the edge is here. So many edges are there. One by one edge we are going on deleting from the set of edges. Set of edges means what? It will consider all the edges present into it with their weights. Each one of the edges will be going on deleted one by one. After deleting, that edge is accepted in the minimum spanning tree if it is not forming a cycle. If it is forming a cycle, then that edge is discarded. Let us see how we are going to do. So here initially we are having here no edges considered. So totally there are 9 trees here. Even a node will make a tree. What is a tree? Tree is a collection of 0 or more nodes. So here one node is there. So this is a tree. This is tree. So there are individually 9 trees here. 0 to 8. So individually 9 trees are there. So out of this graph, this is the first step. In the second step, out of this given graph, delete that edge from the edge set which is having minimum cost. So out of all these, the minimum cost is 2. Out of these, all costs of these edges, the minimum cost is 2 here. So now I am deleted from that edge set 2 and I have taken it in my minimum spanning tree. So step by step if we go on like this, we will finally find out the minimum spanning tree with n minus number, n minus 1 number of edges. So here 7 to 6 edge is having the minimum cost 2. Now after deleting that from the edge set, how many trees will be there? This is one tree. This is one tree plus 7 trees. So totally 8 trees are there. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 8 trees will be there. Now here, 0's root node is 0, 1's root node is 1, 8 root node is 8. In the similar way, this is a tree. So the root node of this one is 6. Consider the minimum root node value. 6 is the root of 7. 6 is the root of 7. Who is the root of 6? 6 itself is the root of 6. Who is the root node of 7? 6 is the root node of 7. These two are forming one tree and 6 is the root of this tree. Then after this one, next minimum edge is this one. 2 to 8, we are having 4. This is the minimum cost. If I consider this now here in the next step. So now I have formed how many trees? This is 1 tree, 2 tree, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 trees are there. What is the root of this tree? Root of this tree is 6. What is the root of this tree? Consider the minimum vertex. Minimum vertex here is 2. So 2 is the root of this tree. 6 is the root of this tree. 2 is the root of this tree. Similarly, next one here. After considering this 4, next minimum here we can take 4. See here, both of them, this also is 4, this also is 4. Anyone you can take first. Arbitrarily, I have taken here this one as first. You can take that one also as the first for considering in the tree. Now here, after considering this, see here, 5, 6 and 7 form one tree. 2 and 8 form one tree. These all are another trees. Root node of this one is, which is minimum vertex? 5. So 5 is the root node of this tree. 2 is the root node of this tree. 1 is the root node, 0 is the root node, 3 and 4 are the root nodes now here. So now after considering these edges, are they forming any cycle? No, they are not forming any cycle. So they can be considered as in the minimum spanning tree. So in the next step, so the next minimum value here is 8. Okay, so here 8. So when I add this 8 into my tree, is it forming a cycle here? It is not forming a cycle. So it can be accepted in our minimum spanning tree. Then among 0 and 1, which is the root node? Yes, 0 is the root node here, 2 is the root node and here 5 is the root node. In the next step, we are considering here what? Next, smallest edge is from 8 to 6. From 8 to 6, I am having 12 is my next smallest cost. But if I consider 8 to 6, now see here if I draw this, this will form one cycle here. So when it is forming a cycle, it is not a minimum spanning tree. So So now you are discarding this edge 8 to 6. You are not including in your MST, that is minimum spanning tree. Okay. Then after that we are going for the next one. So next one which we are considering here is, next smallest is this one, 14. So 2 to 3. After adding this edge 2 to 3, is it forming a cycle in the graph? No, it is not forming. So this edge can be considered for MST. Now for this whole, see now this whole tree is connected here. This whole tree is forming one tree. This is one tree. This is one tree. Root node of this tree is 0. Root node of 4 is 4. Root node of this is what? Which is the minimum vertex here? 2. So 2 is the root node of this one. Okay. Similarly, I don't have space here. So directly I have written only. Next we are considering here 8 to 7 edge. From 8 to 7. 8 to 7. If I take 8 to 7 here, see if I take 8 to 7 here, what it will happen again now? It is forming a cycle. So it is forming a cycle. So I am discarding it. So next we are taking what? 0 to 7 here. So we are taking 0 to 7. So here 0 to 7. What is this? 16 is its cost. So is it forming this edge cycle? Is it forming a cycle? No, it is not forming a cycle. So this edge is considered. And see, this complete is a tree here. What is the root node of that tree? Yes, smallest node is 0. So 0 is the root node of this tree. Next one, 3 to 4. 18. If I consider this 3 to 4, is it forming a cycle? No, it is not forming a cycle. So I can accept this in my minimum spanning tree. And now see, after accepting this one, let us count how many edges we have considered now here. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 8 edges we are having. So now how many vertices we are having? 9. How many spanning tree edges we have found here? 8. So this is a minimum spanning tree using the Kruskal's algorithm. That is, if it is having n vertices, its MST will be having n minus 1 edges into the minimum spanning tree. Okay. Here we are going to see the tabular method of this Kruskal's algorithm. In the exam, if they ask previously whatever I have explained, don't do that. You have to always do the tabular method for the calculation. So what, the same graph we have considered here, which I had explained previously. So for that graph, I have done a list here. What is that list telling you? It is telling you it is a sequence of the edges with their costs. Sequence of edges with their cost in the ascending order. Ascending order of the cost, we are going to write the list here. So starting from the cost 2 till the last, all the edges I have written here. So edge, cost, edge, cost, edge, cost. So starting from 2 till 28, maximum 28 is the cost of the edge here. So I have done a list. Then now coming to column headers. So now here, every time one by one edge I started considering, okay, is it not? One by edge I have considered, no? Like that deleted edge u, v you are going to write here. Then whatever find of u, what is find of u? Find of u means it is finding the root of the node u. Find of v, it is finding the root of node v here. Then output, whatever you are getting here, u and v that you are writing here. What are these now? These are the roots of the vertices. Initially, same root node is same as that of the index. Initially, root node of 0 is 0, 1 is 1, 2 is 2. Initially, we had trees, no? All 9 trees. Like that, we are having here root nodes. So, first for the initial step, what we are going to consider here is, first, which is the minimum cost here? 2. Okay, which is the minimum cost here? 2. So which is that edge? That edge is 6 to 7, u, v. 6 to 7 is the edge here. Find of u, what is the root node? See, find of u means find of 6. Find of 6 will find the root of 6. What is the root node of 6? See, root node of 6 is 6 itself. Root node of 6 is 6. Next, find of V. What is the root node of V? V is 7 here. What is the root node of 7? It is 7 itself. What is I now? I is 6, J is 7. This itself is my output. I am considering this. Okay, I am considering this in my MST. I am considering this in my MST. Now what you are going to do? Union I, J. Union I, J means what? What is my I? 6. What is my J? 7. I union of 6, 7 means store. Previously we have studied, is it not? Store 6 as the root node of 7. So store 6 as the root node of 7. Remaining else, everything is same. This is completing your 1H. Okay? Which is, this one is over. Which is the next one now? 2 to 8. So this edge is considered in my MST. Next one is second step, 2 to 8. So now 2 to 8. So I is equal to, find of U, find of 2. Root node of 2 is 2 itself. Root node of 8. Root node of 8 is 8 itself. So I am, I and J are different. So 2 and J. See, remember, these two should be different. Then only you are going to consider that in your graph. If these two are same, then we are not going to consider. Means it forms a cycle. 2, 2, 2, it forms a cycle there. Loop, it forms a loop there. So we are not considering. This 2 to 8 we will consider. Next, union of I and J. What is my I? 2. What is my J? 8. So what does this 2 union 8 means? Store 2 in the root of 8. So store 2 in the 8. Everything else is same. Done. Next one, which is the smallest? 5 to 6. 5 to 6. What is the root node? I and J. Again, root node of 5, root node of 6. Root node of 5 is 5. What is root node of 6? Root node of 6 is 6. Both are different. So we are considering it. 5 union 6. Store 5 in the place of 6. Store 5 in the place of 6. Everything else is same here. This is over. Next, 5 to 6 over. This one, next, 0 to 1. 0 to 1. So, root node of 0. See, finding the root node of 0 is 0. Root node of 1. Root node of 1 is 1. Both are different. So, I am considering this. What we have to do next? 0 union 1. Store 0 in the place of 1. Store 0 in the place of 1. This is 0, 2, 3, 4, 5, 5, 6 and 2 as it is. Next, 2 to 5. Next step is 2 to 5. Root node of 2. Root node of 2 is 2 itself. Root node of 5. Root node of 5 is 5 itself. Both are different. I am considering in the output. Next, 2 union 5. Means store 2 in the place of 5. 5, here I am storing 2. Everything else is same. Done. Next, after 2 to 5, we are having 6 to 8. 6 to 8. Root node of 6. Root node of 6 is 5. See here, it is not the original number. 6, it should be 6, but it is 5. Go to 5th place. Go to 5th place. See, this also is not original. In the 5, 5 should be there, but 2 is there. Now go to 2. Yes, I am in 2, 2 is there. So 2 is considered as the root node. Understood how we are doing? To find the root of 6. Go to 6 here. So in the place of 6, I am having 5, which is not the actual root node. So now go to 5th place. So in the 5th place, 2 is there. Again, 5 and 2 different. So 2, go to 2 again. Come to 2 here. 2 and 2 same. So now 2 is considered as the root node. Next, 8. Root node of 8 here is 2 again. See, 2 and 2 is 2 and 8 different. So go to 2. 2, 2. See, 2 and 2 same. So 2 is again the root node. Now see here, both of them are same, so you are not considering here. Discarding, you are discarding this one, and as it is you are going to write no union done, nothing. So like this you are going to discard this one. So like this I have solved all the columns here. Now one more thing I want to clarify here. See 5 and 6 5 and 6, so you have considered 0 and 1 0 and 1, you have considered 2 and 5 2 and 5. See, don't think that if these two numbers are same then only they will be considered. Okay, it is not like that. Now you can see in this one here. Okay, so in the edge 0 to 7. So now what is the root node of 0? It is 0. What is the root node of 7? See, root node of 7 here, root node of 7 is 6, not the original number. So go to 6. So if I go to 6 here, it is 5, not original number. Again go to 5. If I go to 5, here I am having 2. Go to 2 here, in the place of 2 I am having 2. So root node will be 2 now. Root node will be 2. See, root node of 7 is 2. These two are different now here. 0 and 7, 0 and 2. Still they have considered, because these two numbers are different. So like this we are going to solve here. Now finally, when you will stop? Many edges are there still. After 3 to 4, 4 to 5, 1 to 7, 3 to 5 are there. But how I am stopping now? See, there are how many vertices? 9 vertices. How many edges we have considered? 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 8 edges are already considered. So it has already formed the minimum spanning tree. Finally, with these edges, 6 to 7. So these edges, you are going to draw the graph. In the graph, include only. Finally, you have to draw a graph. I don't have place here, so I have not drawn. Finally, after that, you have to draw the graph with including only these edges. 6 to 7, 2 to 8, 5 to 6. This all edges you have to include. So this will finish your Kruskal's algorithm for finding the minimum spanning tree.